Hello friends, today we will see how to draw isometric box. This comes under unit number 5, isometric projections. And this is a very basic step. Without this step, you cannot complete any problem. So understand this step very properly. And if you have any difficulty, you can ask me in a comment box. So let's start with the procedure. Before drawing the box, first understand the orthographic projection concept. Now here they have given a box with the length 100, width 60 and height is equal to 60. Now we already know how to take a front view, top view and side view. So if you see from the front, then you will get a front view of 100 as a length and the height as a 60. When you see from the top, this blue color surface will appear over here and the dimensions are 100 and 60. Same way you can plot the side view. So this green color surface is visible to you from side and this is nothing but a left hand side view because this direction is for the front. So this becomes your left hand side and this view will give you the left hand side view. So here you can see the green color surface is appearing with the dimensions of 60 by 60. So this is nothing but orthographic projections for the given box. Okay. So front view, top view and LHSV. This is a standard presentation of the orthographic projections. But when you are dealing with the isometric problems, they will not give you all three views, but they will give you minimum two views. So in this problem, you can see here, see they have given two views only, front view and LHSV. And the dimensions are given over here, but they will mention you the origin. So here they have mentioned the origin. So whatever this view, I don't know. See, when you see this problem and these two views, you cannot say this is the front view or this is a side view. Okay. So you have to focus on the origin. And here, this view is on the right of the origin, you can say. See, if I consider origin over here, then this view is exactly on the right of the origin. So when you consider origin in the isometric view, you have to draw this front view as per our given question, or even if you don't know the view, then you have to draw it on the right side of the origin on the isometric planes. And obviously the side view will come on the left side. So no matter whether they have mentioned the name of the views, you focus on the origin, okay, and proceed. I repeat here, see, this view is on the right of the origin. So here, this is the origin, so you have to draw it on the right side, okay? And other view will come on the left automatically. Okay, so let's start with the problem, so idea will be more clear to you. First, draw a horizontal line and try to keep this line at the bottom of the page because whatever the construction is above this edge, okay? So try to keep this line at the bottom of the page. Now draw a vertical line intersecting with this horizontal line and it must be a perpendicular to the horizontal line. Name the intersection O. This is a very much important point, that is origin, okay, and that will decide the views, where to place the views. Now draw 30 degrees a line from the origin on both sides. Now start with the actual dimensions. Now as per our question, okay, we have a length, okay, of the front view is 100 mm. So from origin you take 100 mm over here. Now height is 60, so from origin take the 60 mm, okay. And considering the side view, again the base is 60 mm. On all the three axes, now we have plotted all the required dimension. See, in isometric always you have to draw three dimensions first. That is L, B, H, length, breadth and height. So as per given question, length is 100, breadth or width you can say is a 60 and height is 60. Now draw parallel to the vertical lines through the end of 30 degree inclined lines. So one from here and one from here. Now this line has the same length like this vertical. So 60, 60 and 60. After this, you draw parallel to the 60 mm. Okay. Through the ends of this vertical line, or you can simply connect this two end points. Okay. So you'll get the required line, but make sure that this should be parallel with the base line, that is 60 mm. Similarly, now draw 100 mm a parallel line through the end points of the vertical line, but again cross check whether this line is parallel to this. Now draw parallel to this means to this 60 mm, okay, through this intersection, okay, and having the same length. Then at the end, again parallel to this 100 mm means parallel to this means over here, the joining these two end points. This is how you can complete the required box in an isometric drawing. I hope the idea is very much clear to you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.